Good morning, everyone. Happy Tuesday. Jeanette Biro here. I'm a medium and a channeler. Welcome to your weekday daily card reading where we dive into the cards, see what's in store with a message from Spirit. This week, I'm using the Awakening Avalon Oracle deck. So let's see what's in store. If you're wanting to purchase that deck, there is a link in the description box down below. Okay, let's see. Spirit, what's up today? They're like, oh, if only you knew. And then I'm like, well, why don't you let me know? And they just started laughing. And they're showing me like the vastness of what's up in the universe is just, they're saying it's magnificent. The amount of stuff that we have, the amount of stuff that we have changing right now is of epic proportions is what they're showing me. And they're saying it's happening above and it's happening below, meaning like on our planet, that we are just such a piece of such a greater galactic shift happening within this whole kind of Milky Way galaxy as well. So it's, they're like, it's a big deal. Everything that's happening right now is a big deal on so many levels. Very interesting. So let's see what's happening in the cards here. There's a funny energy about today too. Funny as in like humorous. I don't know if you're feeling it too, and maybe you're not. Maybe it's just me, but I feel this like there's a humor to the energy today in general. And not just my spirit guides, but like the energy. We shall see. Oh, very interesting. Okay, so with everything, this makes sense. With everything happening in the energies, in the universe, all of these changes, we are being really guided to anchor our energy. And this is how we go about doing it, is what Spirit is saying. So, first of all, the first card out was Time to Smudge. This card makes me laugh, so maybe this is what I was feeling. This card makes me laugh because sometimes it feels like there's so much craziness going on in our lives. We literally need to smudge like that big. We need this massive like cloud of sacred smoke to clear our space. Now, for some of you, it may be sacred smoke that you use for smudge. Some it might be incense, Palo Santo. Maybe it's essential oils. You can even just use air and light. If you open up all of your windows, all of your doors, let the air move through your whole house with the intent of it clearing your energy, you can smudge that way as well. You can also use your own light from your heart space, and you just imagine it beaming out to every corner of your room and every room of your house. You can do that as well. But there's an energy right now where Spirit is saying, it's worthwhile cleansing your energy and your space right now for it to be fresh and new. And they're like, part of it is because of all the changes that are happening and are to happen, but part of it is also this rapid renewal and regeneration which requires cleansing. So this is also like, if you were to do like a weekly smudge, it would probably be a really good thing. And I think that's something I'm going to take on too. So this would probably be a really good idea. Now, in connection with doing that reset as well, there's an invitation to step into our root chakra. And this is interesting because I'm talking about root chakra on Wednesday in Cosmic Consciousness. So this card says ground into the earth, and this makes a lot of sense. When we have our energy grounded into earth, grounded into Mother Nature, we feel more stable, we feel more secure and safe, we feel held and cared for. And that is that rooted energy. It is so valuable. So something as simple as sitting on the earth, you know, whether you're able to sit flat on the earth or on a chair with your feet on the ground, connecting that energy of your root chakra to the earth can help you feel really grounded. The thing with this is it requires like patience and time spent. So you actually have to spend the time to root your energy and visualize roots coming down from your feet or your root chakra into the earth and like anchoring you there and feeling that energy exchange. But if you do that, there's such a beautiful grounding and steadiness that can come from it as you continue to move through these changes and change your frequency. There's also such a recalibration energy in the connection to Mother Earth too. So again, such valuable, sorry, spirit's talking. Yes, such valuable energy available to you through the earth. Very interesting. Now, in that energy as well, once you have smudged your energy and you've grounded your energy into the earth, gratitude, as we know, this is like a magic tool. Gratitude is such a fast, effective way to shift your energy. If you are feeling chaos, if you are feeling sadness, if you are feeling anger, gratitude can come in such a beautiful way. Now, it's not about false positivity, though. I want to say with gratitude, it's not like you just slap a band-aid of everything is okay and I'm so grateful. If you are hurting, you are hurting and you need to be seen by yourself. Like, you need to see yourself. You need to experience what you're experiencing. But from that experience, you then can pull into what am I grateful for in this experience. And sometimes it's only the smallest things we can find to be grateful for. However, that energy of gratitude can help re-energize us, help fill our life force energy, help bring our frequencies back up. The same goes for, though, if you have really positive experiences and it's something that, you know, caught you off guard and you're like, wow, I never knew I would have this opportunity. And sometimes we don't know how to sit in that energy. Be grateful in the moment. Take the time to breathe in that bounty that just arrived on your doorstep. Feel it fully. Because then when you're having times where you're really low or something hard has happened, you can go back to how it felt when that bounty came in and you can run that energy through your body again and lift up your frequency. So gratitude needs the time to be felt, but it is so incredibly powerful, so powerful to shift your energy and your frequency. And in that, we also then get to remember with this Your Choice card, it says, welcome the choice in every moment. We kind of talked about with that with gratitude, where we get to choose in any moment how we want to be as a result of what's happening. This is also, though, coming in because a lot of you are being given different energies and experiences of choice points. And I don't mean exit points when I say that. I mean different path, kind of like a Y in the road or a fork in the road type situation. You're coming into those experiences where you're going to have a fork in the road where you get to decide, am I aligned with going to the left or to the right? Which one is that for you? Which one are they? What do they mean to you? You have choice in the moments and you are stepping into some really beautiful moments coming up here where you really are helping to dictate your destiny in that co-creation. And so I think that's really why this energy of like smudge, have your energy clean and clear, root your energy into the earth so you're grounded and stable, step into the energy of gratitude, because if you are in these energies, when you come to these choice points of fork in the road, you're gonna make some really beautiful decisions based on your authentic self. And I think this is where the magic is. This is fantastic. So I will leave you with that for today. That's just so lovely. And yeah, thank you all so much for joining me as always. Again, if you want to join me for Cosmic Consciousness tomorrow night, you can sign up at avalonspirit.com under Cosmic Consciousness Circle. And I hope to see you there. So thank you as always, everyone, for joining me on these videos. I appreciate you so much and your comments, your kindness. It goes a long way. So all my love to you. I will see you all tomorrow.